Back in the days, the 3D printers were like dinosaurs, big, clunky and expensive, but now they are everywhere. You can find them for all sorts of prices and sizes, and people are using them to make everything from prototypes to products to art. People are always asking me what 3D printer to buy for their kit. My go-to answer is the Aoseed X-Maker. It's small and easy to use even for beginners. It's also fully enclosed, so it's safe for children. And it comes with a bunch of kid-friendly software and ready-to-print toys. In this video, I'm going to show you everything you want to know about the Aoseed X-Maker 4.0, a beginner-friendly 3D printer that's perfect for small spaces. We'll go over what it can do and I'll show you how to set it up, load the filament and print your first 3D models. I'll also give you some tips on how to get the best results from your prints. So let's check it out and see what the X-Maker brings to the table. But before we dive in, let's check what's in the box. The printer comes with everything you need to get started, a quick start guide and a certificate of compliance, pliers, a maintenance toolkit with a USB stick with dedicated software and some ready-to-print 3D models, the printer itself, which is actually very well and safely wrapped and protected, and a small roll of PLA filament. The X-Maker looks like a kid's toy, but it's a powerful tool. It's built like the professional, industrial-grade 3D printers I use at work, only smaller. It has similar functionality, temperature range and speed, so the X-Maker is definitely not just a toy, it's an appealing version of an industrial-grade device. The printer has a clear door and windows, allowing you to see the printing process while also keeping children's fingers away from the hot nozzle, which is a good safety measure. To prepare the printer for printing, install the filament holder by inserting it into the hole on the side and gently twisting it clockwise. Then plug the power cable into the socket at the back. Next, remove the locking elements from the printer bed and ensure that the magnetic mat is fully aligned with the bed. The mat has a special coating that makes filament stick well, but it's also easy to remove and clean. Now we can power on the printer and finish setting it up. Once turned on, the LED lights inside and outside illuminate the printer, making it even more visually appealing. I appreciate this feature. Setting up the X-Maker, it's super easy. It's a wireless printer, so you'll need to connect it to your Wi-Fi network first. The printer will walk you through the process, so it's a breeze. Once it's connected, you'll be able to send 3D models straight from your PC or tablet. But now for the filament. Cut off the twisted end with the included pliers, not necessarily scissors, because you might end up with a weird angle that's harder to thread through the printer. Once the filament is cut and straightened, thread it through the printer. It might be a bit tricky, but just be patient. Once it's in, go to the screen and press Load Filament to heat up the nozzle and start pulling the filament through. The printer comes with a PLA filament, which is easiest to work with. It doesn't need high temperatures and it's what most people start with. The printer can also handle ABS filament, which is more durable than PLA, but requires higher temperatures. And even though it's not advertised, thanks to its range of temperature settings, this printer can technically handle PETG filament, which is the most durable filament, but also the hardest to process. I'll try to create a profile for PETG later in the video and see if I can actually print something with it. So, to get started, let's insert the USB stick into the printer and press the print. For the test, I would recommend the crocodile because it's small and quick to print. Once we got the model, the printer will copy it to its internal drive, so we can print it again later without the USB stick. Now, press start. The printer will heat up and home the nozzle and the bed. We don't need to level the bed or calibrate anything because the printer is basically plug and play. Once it's ready, it will start printing. There's nothing else you need to do at this point, just sit back and relax. The display will show you the remaining time to complete the print, and once it's done, you'll have a nice crocodile peg. Just remove the raft, which is the base that the model was printed on. So this printer comes with four apps. The main app called XMaker, where you can choose from a selection of hundreds of ready-to-print figures and toys. The XPrint for more traditional STL workflow, such as converting, scaling and manipulating 3D models from various sources. This app is for you. Magic 3D, if you like to easily manipulate basic shapes, build 3D models from scratch or modify existing models. And Art 3D to modify shapes by squeezing them like a clay, which children will enjoy. All of these apps can import most 3D formats and convert them into the internal Xcode format, which is a file format used by Aoseed printer. But don't worry, you don't have to convert anything once you've created an object. You can send any model straight to the printer via Wi-Fi. If you're into more classic 3D experience, XPrint is your app. Resizing the models was super easy. Just click on the model and the controls popped up on the right side of the screen. Once we were happy with the size and position of the model, we were ready to slice it. Slicing is necessary for two reasons. First, 3D printers can only print one layer at a time. And second, slicing helps ensure that the model prints correctly and without gaps or holes. The XPrint app slices our 3D model into layers and adds a base for the model to print on. The output is a series of G-code files, which is the language that 3D printers use to control their movements. We can save the sliced model to USB drive and stick it into the printer, or just send it to the printer via Wi-Fi. The printer will take care of the rest. Slicing 3D models is like baking a cake, but with more science and less sugar. You can't put a whole cake in the oven at once, so you have to cut it into layers and bake each layer separately. Slicing a 3D model is the same thing. The slicer cuts the model into a series of thin layers called layers. The thinner the layer, the smoother the print will be, but the longer it will take to print. Once the model is sliced, the slicer generates a series of G-code files, and G-code is the language that 3D printers use to control their movements. Here's a nice geometry dash demon. My son is going to love this. By the way, the XMaker app can be installed on iPad or Android tablet. So with a little help loading the filament into the printer, your children can pick and print any model from the app without any hassle. The app slices the models automatically and sends it to the printer. It couldn't be any easier. Next, let's try converting a 2D drawing into a 3D model. I'm going to use a free online converter for this. Now I've converted the logo to 3D, so I'll throw it into the XMaker app on my PC to scale it, slice it and send it straight to the printer via Wi-Fi. All I have to do is tap on the printer and click start. I like that the XMaker is wireless, no cables, no USB sticks, it's the future of 3D printing. Looks like I made a mistake. Some of the letters in this logo are loose, so it fell apart when I tried to remove the raft. But hey, at least I'm giving it a try, right? I'm going to upload this logo to Magic 3D and add a stand to it.
And before we carry on, make sure you're subscribed.
The app is super easy to use. You can rotate, drag, move and extend any shape. Voila, here's the Family Pop TV logo, revision 2. Now I'll check it out in XPrint and slice it. You might ask, why do I have to use XPrint? I don't have to, but I'm a bit of a perfectionist. I want to make sure my model is center and looks good when it's sliced. Okay, it's all ready to be printed. I'll press the button and the printer should start its job. Next up, I'm going to swap the yellow PLA for black PLA. No need to tweak any settings, so I'll just unload the yellow filament, load the black one and send the 3D logo straight to the printer from my PC. That's it. I'm estimating a print time of around 4 hours since the logo is 4x4 inches and almost an inch deep. I can't wait to see how it turns out. I also modified the base of the model so it won't print a raft. Instead, it will print a brim, which is a thin outline that helps the model stick to the bed. A raft is like a little sacrificial layer that gets printed first. It helps the model stick to the bed and prevents warping. Once the model is finished printing, you can peel off the raft. A brim is like a skirt that goes around the outside of the model. It also helps the model stick to the bed, but it's not as thick as a raft.
Wow, look at this.
So after 4 hours of printing, we've got our logo done. Let's take a look. Now for the last test. As I mentioned earlier, the printer can handle PETG filament, but I'll need to manually override the settings in the profile. I'll use XPrint for this test because it has more advanced features. I've scaled the model down so I can quickly test the settings. PETG requires higher temperatures than PLA, so I'll set the bed temperature to 60 to 70 degrees Celsius and the nozzle to 230 degrees Celsius or even higher. The nozzle temperature is at 235 degrees Celsius and the layers are consistent. The model is printed, let's check it out. It's not perfect and it would probably require more tweaks like print speed and maybe a bit more temperature. But I just wanted to prove the point, the XMaker 3D printer is not a toy at all. It's a well-designed 3D printer that can handle various materials and give high-quality prints.
Guys, look what I just printed.
The XMaker is a smart 3D printer for the whole family.
So cool!
It's easy to use for kits with precise models and toy designing apps. It also has a walled garden of apps so your kits won't stumble upon anything inappropriate. For more experienced makers, the XMaker has a USB port and a full-featured XPrint slicer. The only issue is the buzzing sound from the extruder fan, but it's quieter than the other printers, for example Tinner 2, which we reviewed last year. The XMaker is a bit expensive, but worth it for parents who want to introduce their kids to 3D printing. The build quality is great, the apps and models are helpful, and it's a versatile starting point. You can buy the printer on Aoseed website, and I've put the links in the video description. Just so we know, we're not affiliated with Aoseed in any way. They send us this printer for free to review, but all of our opinions are our own, so you can be sure this is the real thing. If you have any questions, requests, or just want to say hi, leave us a comment below. Thanks for watching. Catch you guys on the next one.